Wednesday, and today we leave for Canada. Good morning. Damn, beautiful day to go traveling, eh? Sorry. One and only time I'll do that. Am I trying to be Canadian? Yeah. Okay, we are just about ready. Knock on wood, making good time. Time to start loading the car. The car's loaded, we are ready to go. I'm so excited.
Yeah, pretty close indeed. Yeah, 10, we tried to get out by 10. Oops, sorry. And it's 10:15, so let's go.
Well, guess what we did after I boasted about leaving on time or almost on time? We forgot our coats, so we had to come back. And now it's 10:40, so unfortunately, comparable to previous years, this is more like it.
Hello, puppy. Are you driving the car?
Are you the driver of that car?
So does Blue Heron. Oh, okay. Okay, we found the perfect picnic spot right here. And we have spreads and cheeses and my leftover sandwich I had from yesterday. And I have traditional pepperoni. And mom's right there just enjoying the scenery. I don't blame her. Beautiful view. I'm really glad that we had lunch here. I'm really glad that we found this rest area. Perfect place to have our picnic. So we're able to go down and just stand right by the river. We'll do that for a couple of minutes as the food goes down, and then we are onward to en route to Ithaca. We're actually going to stay in Ithaca, New York overnight, and then we'll be in Canada tomorrow. I'm loving the hotel room and time for dinner. We are finally here in Ithaca. Yeah, so we are going to head to a Latin American restaurant first, and if they have a long wait, then we're gonna go to the Thai place that was near it. But back in Ithaca, it has been a year since we've been here, and I love this town. It's very beautiful. It's kind of old and kind of new simultaneously, I think. You know, me and mom kind of made a stink about forgetting our winter coats, but the thing is, it is really warm tonight. No, but it's supposed to get down to the 40s, I mean the 30s and 40s when we're up in Canada. You're gonna do what? Oh, some window shopping? Oh, okay. What? Oh, your mask.
Probably should have mine on. Bickering Twins, I keep forgetting the name. Bickering Twins. Sorry, my hand was like right in the...
Ooh, this looks really good. Oh, wow. I ate well today. Now mom wants to do some window shopping. Let her have her fun here. Hey, good morning, everybody. Yeah, the weather's not very good, but it's supposedly only going to be rainy today. And then we're supposed to have about 3 or 4 days of good weather. And I found out race day is actually going to be good as well. Earlier in the week, they were calling for a 60% chance of rain on race day. And when I packed, I was packing a lot of stuff that I would run in the rain. I did run a 10K in the rain once, and it was raining pretty steadily. Not heavily, but steadily. But now it's supposed to be good, so... fingers crossed. Day two of our Canadian journey. Yeah, had I had the time yesterday, I wanted to actually lay out all of my running stuff and vlog that, but I didn't really get a chance to. We didn't really have time, and I was very busy this past week. So hopefully when we get up to Toronto, I'll be able to lay everything out on the bed and show you what I brought.
Yeah, what a day. At least we're not doing anything outdoorsy.
Yeah, so as you can see, the weather's really gross. But mom wants to check out a couple of stores before we head up to Niagara Falls. All of this is supposed to move out by the afternoon. Really hope it does.
we are now leaving Ithaca, and we're just going to, we're going to drive to a lake, just check it out really quickly.
Okay, we are at Stewart Park right now, and we're walking down a path that is supposed to lead to the edge of the lake. Cayuga Lake is amazing, and it stretches for miles. It is raining. That was our cue. This is it. We are just a few hundred feet from the Canadian border, from customs. And we are going to be in at any moment.
Like 40 minutes looking for the
bridge. Yeah, looking for the bridge. So once you get into Niagara Falls, New York, everybody, just take Main Street all the way to the Rainbow Bridge. Do not use your GPS. The GPS gave us the runaround and took us to a crossing that we were not allowed to cross. Yes, we have made it. We are just checking into the hotel right now. Good evening, guys. We are in our hotel, and they said that we would get a view of the falls. Unfortunately, that's not the case with us. It's okay. It's not bad. We have this tree blocking the way, but you know what? Better to have more trees than less trees. Now, onward to downtown to get something to eat. What a nice evening. A little breezy, but it feels good. Falls are over there. I'll try to get video of it tomorrow. Unless somebody wants to see it at night. So we're at a place called the Original Kelsey's. You know I'm getting a beer. The desserts are tempting mom. Oh, dinner was good. I am full. Good morning from Niagara Falls. Now I am in the process of reorganizing my running luggage. And I mentioned last night everything that I would bring with me. I was pretty meticulous in my planning here. This is everything that I have laid out on the bed that I have to repack because everything was just getting kind of thrown around. But here's everything. Mom is flabbergasted. She's like, so much stuff. But competitive athletes bring a lot of crap. So I have my athletic jackets here. And actually, this is just a casual wear vest. My running shirts right here. And my running shorts here. And these are just my track pants. I am probably not gonna wear these. I brought my compression pants here. They're long pants, and it's supposed to be 56 by the time of the race. So it'll be a little chilly, but not too bad. And then I just have additional items, my running gloves, headband, and just a few other things. Running shoes will go in here. They're just kind of laying in my trunk right now, but I'll put them in there today. It's my shoe bag. And so I'll just go ahead and repack everything. Today we are going to walk all along the falls. So hoping to get some great video here. We took that tour and we were just getting hit with water, so our eyes were basically closed the whole time. It's incredible. No words. I have no words. IHOP now, and I'm just gonna eat, and then we are going to head out. We should be there probably by 5 o'clock. It's 70 miles away, so it should take about an hour, hour and a half. I made a reservation for an Italian restaurant tonight because I totally forgot that today is Friday and a lot of restaurants will be booked. So we are doing Italian. It's at a place by the waterfront. I forgot the name. I'll find out. But we are headed to Toronto, and in two days is the race. We are here in Toronto and now we're looking for the hotel, and we are stuck in very heavy traffic. We are finally here and Mom is checking into the hotel, so we can remain parked in the garage for the next couple of days until we have to leave. No more driving in the city. I'm very excited though, because I've been seeing a lot of signs on the highway announcing the closures of certain streets in Toronto for the marathon, and it's getting me a little pumped up. But we're here somewhat on the early-ish side, so I think that we're gonna actually finally be able to take a nap and then kind of do a little bit of a test run to the place where I have to pick up my packet. And then tomorrow I also want to find out where the start line is. So we'll do a test run then as well. We are on our way to dinner now, and I slept, did you? Yeah, it's been 7 years since I've been here. No, but 7 years. 2015 was the last time I was here, at least. Did you go any other time after we went? It's been that long. Doesn't feel like it, doesn't seem like it, but yes.
The cute menu.
I haven't had lasagna in a long time. That was a pretty decent Italian place. Yeah, it wasn't bad. Now we're gonna go for an evening stroll.